couple of weeks ago, I did a review of the movie Excalibur. And when I was telling you about Liam Neeson and that, I mentioned another movie called Next of Kin. So before I got too late and I forgot, I wanted to go and do a review of it. So we watched it the other night. Here we go. I know there's a glare because of the lights, but that's the box art. Next of Kin is a movie that came out in 1989, but you've probably never heard about it. It stars some pretty big hitters. Patrick Swayze, if you noticed his face on the box art, plays a character by the name of Truman Gates. His wife is played by Helen Hunt, and one of his brothers, Briar, is played by Liam Neeson. Then you're also recognized Bill Paxton, who plays his younger brother, Gerald, and a young Ben Stiller, who, this is fairly early in his career, is the son of a mob boss. His name is Lawrence, the Ben Stiller's character's name is Lawrence Isabella. Rounding out the cast that hopefully you recognize, especially if you're sci-fi fans, if you ever watched Babylon 5, and hopefully you did because it was an excellent sci-fi series, then you could recognize Jakar out of his Narn makeup as the mob boss John Isabella. The actor's name is Andreas Katsoulis. He's Greek, but he's playing an Italian in this movie. And then his right hand, the mob boss's right hand, his nephew, his chief enforcer, is played by the actor Adam Baldwin, better known as Jane to those of us who love the sci-fi series Firefly. And there will be some other character actors that you'd hopefully recognize in this movie, but those are the key actors. If you wanted to sum up this movie in one word, it would be revenge. You have two families. You have the Gates family. That's the brothers Truman, Briar, and Gerald, and their extended family. They're from the coal mining region of Kentucky. Then you have the Isabella family, which are basically a mob family who rule Chicago. Now, Truman, Swayze's character, escapes Kentucky, joins the military, and after getting out, he decides to join the police force, and he's stationed there in Chicago, the big city. His younger brother, Gerald, Bill Paxton's character, comes to Chicago to get a job to earn some money, but he doesn't like it there. He doesn't like the big city. He wants to go back to Kentucky as soon as he raises enough money. And his other brother, Briar, Liam Neeson's character, is encouraging him to come back. Well, unfortunately for young Gerald, he's working for a vending machine company that the mob is trying to take over. When they try to hijack his truck, he decides to resist, and Adam Baldwin's character, whose name is Joey, basically shoots him in cold blood. He's just mad at him. Watching all this, witnessing it, is Ben Stiller's character, the mob boss's son. Now, there's a little side story here. Joey was figuring he was being groomed to take over the family business. And when Lawrence, Ben Stiller's character, shows up on the scene and starts taking over things, he doesn't like it. And so that's going to be another thread of the story. Anyway, Truman finds out that his brother's been murdered. He's, of course, furious. He's trying to figure out who did it. But meanwhile, he has to take his brother's body back to Kentucky. Well, these are mountain folk, and they have a simple code. Blood needs to be answered with blood. You kill one of ours, we're going to kill one of yours. And Truman tries his best to talk his family out of doing that. Unbeknownst to him, Briar, Liam Neeson's character, decides to come into Chicago and take matters into his own hands. He doesn't want to wait for the police to resolve this. For you guys, there is an awful lot of bloodshed in this movie. I won't spoil it for you, but eventually the whole Gates clan, the extended family, ends up loading up in vehicles and buses and heading to Chicago, and it's a rather large shootout before all is said and done. Eventually there is peace between the two families, but not without a lot of fighting and a lot of interesting, there's crossbows and compound bows and knives. I mean, these are mountain folk, they don't just use guns. Anyway, it's an interesting movie. Helen Hunt's character, you feel sorry for her because she's caught up in this and she doesn't want to be. You know, she's a city girl. She doesn't understand these mountain folk ways. I think personally Liam Neeson does a superb job in the role of Briar. I think he has a decent mountain accent. Neferblatt's poo-pooed it a bit, but I thought it was a pretty decent accent. better than what you often hear in movies. And when you take into the fact that Liam Neeson is not from this country, it's a good job. Swayze's character, he could have done a better job acting. I'll admit he's not necessarily an Oscar-winning actor, but it's okay. And for you ladies, he is delightful to watch, okay? I have to admit, he's tasty. He's got just the right amount of muscle on that body. He was a dancer, and it showed. So you get to see him shirtless in several scenes, but for you ladies out there, if you really want to get a better view of Patrick Swayze, watch the movie Roadhouse. Maybe I'll tell you about that one sometime. But that's all. That gives you the gist. I don't want to spoil the whole movie for you by telling you everything that happens, but it's pretty good. Guys will enjoy the action, and girls will enjoy Patrick Swayze. That's all for this time. Come back and see me.
See ya.